Okay, here's something pretty basic, but something that everybody's got to know how to do. Changing valve springs, right? So you got your engine on the stand. If you can, it's good to pivot it up, just in case you drop a keeper. You know, maybe you're going to contain it within the head rather than drop it on the floor. So yeah, if you can rotate your engine up, definitely do it. So yeah, in this video, I'm also using the valve spring compressor tool I made in one of the other videos. Pretty easy to do. So you can gun this, or you can do it by hand, it doesn't really matter. So it's good to give it a tap to release the keepers. You can pick these up by hand, or if you have a magnet, you can always use the old magnet. Just don't lose them. Now, if you think you're really good, you can try to not use compressed air to keep the valves up. But you know, there's a chance of dropping a valve. So we're gonna put some air in here. Funny, this is a Milton one. I have a Snap-on one. It glides in like butter, but the ends on this one, I think it's cut too sharp. Valve springs, that is. So the valves, just give them a tug up to seat them. And you can see when you seat them, I don't know if you can see that. Well, it says high, actually. Well, this is a unknown mileage engine. I wouldn't doubt it if it is high. Yeah, but we're gonna check this again a little bit later. So now's the time. If you are doing valve stem seals, now's the time to get that done. So nothing special needed for valve stem seals. You just don't want to nick the valve. Yeah, just pry up. So there's intake and exhaust. factory exhaust brown, factory intake black. So I'm just gonna give the valve a wipe, get rid of any carbon on the top here. You know, if you're super, super concerned about dropping a valve, you put the crank bolt in the end of the crank, you take your 24 mil wrench here, just push the valve down. And then turn the crank to push the valve up. So that's about maxed out for turning the crank, right? So there's no chance of dropping the valve now. Take the wrench back up the crank just in case it decides to go flying, so the wrench doesn't go flying. You're gonna pull these up to close it. There you go. So now there's no chance of dropping that valve. So just giving the head a bit of a wipe. Cleaning it up a tiny bit where the new valve stem seal is going. So the new intake black. Gonna use a little bit of the old oil here to lube this. New exhaust, brown. So just very carefully slide them over the valve, real slow. You don't want to cut the new seal. Then you take your big socket here, and you want to push straight down. You don't need to tap it with a mallet. They go down like butter. Couple of new pack springs. These are a lot taller than the GM ones, and pack intake exhaust winds up being the same spring, unlike the factory GM ones. Now, depending on your tool and how you made it. Yeah, I could actually use a tad bit longer screw, but this is working just fine. You can gun it, you can do it by hand, it doesn't really matter. I like to take my time and line it up. Yeah, I like this style of tool because it doesn't mess with the threads on the head, right? The thread that's getting wear here is of the bolt and of the threads that are in my tool. Right, some of the other ones, you actually screw into the head and that gets the wear. So the way I have this tool built, I bottom this right out and there's enough room. So I know that's where I want to stop. It's where I got it bottomed right out. Right. Okay, if you're a Butterfingers here, maybe have somebody else do it. You don't wanna lose these. If you drop these, actually, if you drop them into the head, you're screwed. Good luck fishing it out, right? But in this case, I got the pan off, no big deal. Could hit them with some assembly lube if you're having trouble with them staying in place. In my case, I'm a bit lazy. I don't want to reach for the assembly lube. I'm just gonna hold these with one hand, and the other hand I'm gonna raise it up here. Those are in place. You know, if you're used to the challenge, just do it like I'm doing. Use both hands. I'm holding everything in place. It's fine. If you're somebody that's easily stressed out, grab the assembly lube. Lube them all up so nothing moves. All right. So that's off. Tools off. So let's see how bad this engine is. Leak down low. Just gonna give them a quick wipe first in case there's any metal from that screw or tool. Any metal shards, just give it a quick wipe. What do you know? This engine's good. Alright, so something pretty simple. Nothing to it. That didn't take more than 15 minutes, but you know, take your time. Probably if you're doing a full set, maybe just get some assembly lube to hold everything in place, and you could actually gun it, but I don't like using the gun because it does tear up the threads on your tool a little bit. All right, so yeah, I hope you hope this was informative to you. If you're watching, if it was and you think it's useful, something you're gonna watch again, yeah, please like and subscribe. I got other videos like this, just kind of day-to-day grind stuff, but it's always good to know, seeing somebody do it in real time. Of course, for me, it just helps me with gives me a little reassurance that I'm doing it correctly and that nothing's gonna go wrong. And for something like this, nothing to fear. You just don't want to lose anything down the head. Big tools are fine, but when you're talking about the retainer keepers, you don't want to lose those down the head here. All right, so yeah, like I said, like, subscribe as always. Peace out.